Many of Israel joined them, but Benathias and his sons gathered in a group apart. Then the officer of the king addressed Benathias, "You are a leader, an honorable and great man in this city, supported by sons and kin. Come now, be the first to obey the king's command, as all the Gentiles and the men of Judah, and those who are left in Jerusalem have done. Then you and your sons shall be numbered among the king's friends, and shall be enriched with silver and gold and many gifts." But Mattathias answered in a loud voice, "Although all the Gentiles in the king's realm obey him, so that each forsakes the religion of his fathers and consents to the king's orders, yet I and my sons and my kin will keep to the covenant of our fathers. God forbid that we should forsake the law and the covenants. We will not obey the words of this king, nor depart from our religion in the slightest degree." As he finished saying these words, a certain Jew came forward in the sight of all to offer sacrifice on the altar and redeem, according to the king's order. Mattathias saw him. He was filled with zeal. His heart was moved at him, and his just fury was aroused. He sprang forward and killed him on the altar. At the same time, he also killed the messenger of the king, who was forcing them to sacrifice. And he tore down the altar. Then he showed his zeal for the law, just as Phinehas did the Zimri, son of Zalun. Then Mattathias went through the city shouting, "Let everyone who is zealous for the law and who stands by the covenant follow after me." Thereupon he fled to the mountains with his sons, leaving behind in the city all their possessions. Many who sought to live according to the righteousness and religious custom went out into the desert to settle there. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.